Students, now we are going to discuss about classification of living world. What is the meaning of classification of living world? Imagine, suppose all the students in our school, not classroom, or entire school, if they are being in the ground. For example, if your parents are visiting our office to call you, suppose if you are being in your classroom, straight away office staff will visit your classroom and they will call the name of the student and you will come out and meet your parent. It is easy. Because it is already classified into various classes. Now, if you are being in the ground, all the students at a time are mingled, not in a form of lines. Then how can you identify? It is how difficult it is. Similarly, study of living organisms, whether it is plants or animals, or even microorganisms like viruses, bacteria, also it is very difficult to understand if it is not classified. So the classification is must. So if the classification has been done, the studying and understanding and comparing the basic characteristic features will be easy for us, you know. So in order to classify, you should identify the living organisms. They compare the similarities and dissimilarities of the organism. On the basis of it, we should classify all the living organisms. So this is called classification of living world. So from this previous chapter, we know that the planet Earth is endowed with living and non-living things. In our daily life, we see several things in and around us. Imagine, you are on a trip to hill station. Suppose if you are going to Ooty or Kodaikanal. If you are visiting Ooty and Kodaikanal, you might have seen lot of things. You might have enjoyed lot of things. You are enjoying the beauty of mountains, dazzling colors of various flowers, various attractive, beautiful flowers, and melodious sound of the birds. You may capturing most of the things you come across in the form of photography. If you have a camera or your cell phone, immediately used to take photographs. Now from this experience, can you mention the object you have come across? Can you record your observation and tablet them? How will you organize the things which have been seen by you? You will place mountain and flowers together, or tall trees and trailing herbs in one category, or the place it in a different category. If you place it in different category, what made you to place them in different category? So classification is essential and could be done only by understanding and comparing the things based on some characters which are resembling and differences. So what are the things which are resembling? These are kept in the same group. What are the things are being different? Differ, they should be keeping away from it. So this chapter, we shall learn about classification of living world in detail. So many attempts have been made in the past to classify the living organism on the earth. Theophrastus, a great scientist, he was called as father of botany. In one month they used to ask, who was called as father of botany? Theophrastus. So Theophrastus, father of botany, used the morphological characters of classify plant into trees, shrubs and herbs. Tall plants are trees, small plants are herbs, intermediate plants are shrubs. In such a way, Theophrastus divided all the plants into three categories. Similarly, Aristotle classified animals into two groups, enema, anema. Enema means with red blood. If the animals with red blood are called as enema, animals without red blood are called as anaema. So anaema, anaema. So in such a way, Aristotle classified the animals. Another scientist, Carolus Linnaeus, classified all the living world into two groups, namely plants and animals, plantae and animalia, based on morphological character. Morphological character means external features or external character. His classification based on Carolus Linnaeus' classification of living world into two groups, namely plants and animals, based on morphological characters. His classification faced major setback because he kept the prokaryotes and eukaryotes were grouped together. Similarly, fungi is a heterotrophic organism. They cannot be able to synthesize their own food because they do not have chloroplast. He kept the fungi in the same plant groups, were placed along with the photosynthetic plants. In course of time, the development of tools compelled taxonomies took for different areas like cytology, cell biology, anatomy, internal structure of plants, embryology, structure of embryo, molecular biology, phylogeny, etc. for classifying organism on the earth. Thus, new dimensions of classification were put forth from time to time. Thereafter, what is the need of classification? This may be asked 2 mark or 3 mark. Why should we classify? So classification is essential to achieve to relate things based on common characteristic features, to define organism based on the salient features, helps in knowing the relationship among different groups of organism. This classification helps in understanding the evolutionary relationship between organisms. That is why classification is needed. Classification of living world. A comparison of classification proposed for classification of living world, I shall explain with a table column later on. See here, we shall see this table column will be helping us to understand about various types of classification. 2 kingdom classification, 3 kingdom classification, 4 kingdom classification, 5 kingdom classification. 2 kingdom classification was proposed by Carolus Linnaeus in the year 1735. He classified the living organism into 2 groups, namely Plantae and Animalium. Then Ernst Haeckel in the year 1866, he classified 3 kingdom classification. He classified all the living organism into 3 categories, namely Protista, Plantae, Animalium. Then Copeland in the year 1956, he classified all the living organism into 4 kingdom, into Monera, Protista, Plantae, Animalium. Then R. H. Whitaker in the year 1969, he classified 5 kingdom classification. He classified all living things into 5 classes, namely Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalium. We shall go through R. H. Whitaker 5 kingdom classification in detail. See here, R. H. Whitaker, an American taxonomist, proposed 5 kingdom classification in the year 1969. The kingdom includes Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalium. The criteria adopted for the classification include cell structure, thallus organization, mode of nutrition, reproduction, phylogenetic relationship. So on the basis of it, these are classified. Whether the cell structure is similar or different, the thallus organization, how the structure of thallus is available, what is the mode of nutrition, how they are taking food, what type of reproduction, whether it is a sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction, or binary fission, or fragmentation, what type of reproduction is followed, what types of phylogenetic relationship between one organism to the other, on the basis of it, Whitaker classified the organism into Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalium. The comparative account of salient features we shall see in your textbook later on. So, this is Whitaker 5 kingdom classification. Some merits and demerits are also there with Whitaker 5 kingdom classification. What are the merits? The 5 kingdom classification is based on the complexity of cell structure and the organization of thallus. It is very good. It is also based on mode of nutrition. This classification will be based on separation of fungi from plants because they cannot be able to synthesize their own food. So they are heterotrophic plant. It shows the phylogeny of living organism. This role can be studied as a merit. What are the demerits? The kingdom Monera and Protista accommodate both autotrophic as well as heterotrophic organisms. The kingdom Monera and Protista accommodate both autotrophic and heterotrophic organisms. The cell wall lacking and cell wall bearing. That means if the organism which are, some of the organisms are having cell wall, some of the organisms do not have cell wall. They are also kept in the same group. So these organisms making these two groups in more heterogeneous. And apart from this, viruses were not included in this system. It is also one of the important demerits. So later on, after five kingdom classification, some other classification also will be have been established. Six kingdom classification, seven kingdom classification, and so on. Karl Moos and co-workers in the year 1990 introduced three domains of the life, wise bacteria, archaea, and eukarya, based on the differences in the rRNA nucleotide sequence. On the base of rRNA nucleotide sequence, lipid structure of the cell membrane, these organisms, all the organisms are divided into three different domains called bacteria, archaea, eukarya. The revised six kingdom classification for living world was proposed by Thomas Cavalier and Smith in the year 1998. And the kingdom Monera is further divided into two different categories, namely Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. Recently, Rogerio and et al. In the year 2015 published the seven kingdom classification, which is recently, Rogerio et al. 2015 published seven kingdom classification, which is practical extension of Thomas Cavalier six kingdom classification scheme. According to this classification, there are two super kingdoms. They are prokaryota and eukaryota. The prokaryota includes two kingdoms, namely Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. The eukaryota includes five kingdoms, namely protozoa, chromista, fungi, plantae, and animalia. So overall, eight kingdoms: Archaebacteria, Eubacteria, protozoa, chromista, fungi, plantae, animalia. So overall, seven kingdoms. A new kingdom, the chromista, was erected, and it includes all algae whose chloroplast contain chlorophyll A and chlorophyll C, as well as various colorless forms that are closely related to them. Diatoms and brown algae, cryptomonads, and oomycetes were placed in this kingdom, in chromista. So this is seven kingdom classification. That's all about types of classification.